So, okay, this is how it will appear when we put some agitated saline into the venous circulation. That is, in the forearm veins, if you put this agitated saline, inject the agitated saline, it will fill only the aria and RV. You can see that aria, RV in the peccal or subcostal fourth chamber view. And you are seeing that only aria, RV are getting absolutely opacified by the contrast, but not at all, LALV and all, not at all getting even opacified. So this is the very important use of agitated saline. You will inject the agitated saline in the IV, intravenously, and you will see for the right to left shunt. That is, anywhere the right to left shunt, all the ASDs may be having, that is left to right shunt is what is the wonder, but minimum right to right shunt will be there during the peak of the respirations and all. Even the PFO also, it can be got out, the right to left shunt can be got out by Valsalva or coughing out. We can get the right to left shunt during the agitated saline. The pulmonary AVMs, that is 5 to 15 cycles, you will get a circulatory left ventricular opacification of the contrast, a slow filling of the contrast in the left ventricle. A large VSDs also may have sometimes the right to left shunt. You can detect that shunt being seen. And the left SVC, that is very important, which we will be discussing in further. So for the intracardiac shunt, you usually contrast echo, there is an ASD or PFO evidence can be got. If there is a large right to left shunt, you will get a continuous shunt, or if the smaller one, you can be getting a phasic respiratory response. That is, during inspiration, it may go to the right to left, or during it is expiration, it will be a left right shunt. So here is an example of a ostium secundum ASD with a contrast filling into the LA. You can see that aria RV are getting contrast, contrast failed, and agitated saline is getting spilled into the LA by the agitated saline during a phasic response. That is, during expiration, inspiration, it is getting into the LA. Similar is the this kind of the patient who didn't had any IAS defect, actually is getting complete filling of the LALV within the one or two cycles. Then it is one of the examples of the sinus venosus ASD, where we are having very difficulty in getting the filling of the left, getting the defect of the ASD, but you are sure that there is a defect because aria RV is usually dilated and there is some sort of hypertension. Then you will be searching for the sinus venosus VSD through the either through the TE, or simply you can get a contrast echo to first justify that the TE is required.